he's really faced with a really unusual problem with Tom Wilkinson's character. Tom Wilkinson's character knows his rights. He's very powerful. He's very smart. He may be out of his mind, but he's within that is this brilliant attorney. He is not to be messed with, and he's in the right. And he also knows. Everything that he says, and he says a lot. Everything that he says, you could very much make a case for being, being part of the internal monologue that Michael Clayton is probably going through all the time at this. I mean, he's very much a voice in his ear. So it's very difficult for Michael Clayton to get a handle on containing this problem. One of the things that we did was to spend a lot of time walking around very large New York law firms. And I was really struck by the huge amount of space and personnel that was sort of behind the scenes that you never, I was unaware that these law firms had these sort of huge back staffs, sort of like the kitchen of a restaurant in a way, places where clients wouldn't go. And we were sort of walking around, and I just, you're always looking for some new arena to put something in. It seemed really untouched. So that was sort of, that was the area. I kept that away, filed that away. I thought, this is a really great place for, there's a lot of drama going on back here, and it's a place I haven't seen. And so that was the beginning of it. The script took a long time because it was such a, I mean, the character was so rich and the environment was so rich. There were so many different ways to go. It was very, it was the kind of thing in its abundance, it led you in a lot of, led me down a lot of different trails or a lot of different versions of this before I finally landed on it. She's a very sympathetic character to me. She's a very lost, villain. She's someone who just is not up to speed on, very formal person, very, a grind. She's a real grind, and she's had to grind her way to get this job, and it means everything to her. And all of a sudden, she's forced into a situation where she has to improvise. And rather than go and ask for help, or rather than, rather than say, I don't know, she pretends that she knows. And that is a big, big mistake for everybody. I mean, I hope it's a ripping yarn, you know? I mean, I hope people are, you know, I mean, you really want people to be saying what happens next. But it really is riding around, it really is following George around and as he really has a very tortured path towards redemption, not a traditional path to redemption.